Hi, David Brella here, and today I'm going to show you how you can use the Windows Bridge for iOS to port an iOS Xcode Objective-C project across to a Visual Studio Windows 10 project. Now, the Windows Bridge for iOS is a cool tool. It will convert the Xcode project over to Visual Studio, but it also lets you edit Objective-C code within Visual Studio. To get started, we're just going to go and download it from GitHub, and we can see that there are many releases here. The one that got released 2 days ago unfortunately has a new runtime and isn't working correctly, so I'm going to go to the previous release from 2 weeks ago. We simply just right-click it, save as, and we save it onto our disk. It's fairly large, so I've already downloaded it. Now, the project that we're going to convert across today is an old game called Canabalt. Now, in this game, it's the typical post-world apocalyptic, you're trying to run and escape. You're trying to see how far you can run before you die. Now, they released this, it was popular, so they ported it across to the iPhone. A couple years later, they went and released all of the source code online for us for free. Now, I've got the source code here, which is up on GitHub. If I right-click, I can download the entire source code. And again, I've already downloaded it because it's fairly large. If we go and look at it here, I can start extracting them. I'll extract the iOS bridge, and I'll extract all the source code of Canabalt. While they're extracting, let's go check it out. So Canabalt is an Xcode project. We can see we've got some Objective-C files here, classes, etc. Now we want to convert this across to Visual Studio Project. So we'll just wait for this to finish. And if we go and have a look at what's inside the WinObjective-C, there's a whole bunch of files, etc. But the one we care about is this Visual Studio importer. If we go back to a Canabalt source code, let's open up a command prompt here, and we'll execute that tool /bin/Visual Studio importer. Now, if we watch here, we'll see that as I run that importer, it'll go and generate a few files. So it's generated the Visual Studio solution for us. If we open that up, it'll take a little while to load, and if we have a look, we've got two projects here, which were from the Xcode project. We've got all the code here. We'll just let it finish loading, and at the same time, we'll get it to do a simple build. And once that's finished building, we can simply run it. So if I hit Control F5, it'll come up. And then it will launch. Now, because it's a Windows 10 app, we could add our own splash screen icon there, but we can see it's loaded up correctly. We can resize it, it resizes correctly. It's got a bit of a border thing, but if we hit play, you can see it starts running. We've got sound, there's click events. It's even got touchscreen, if I touch on the correct bit. So we can see we've got touchscreen, and I've died, and it's a rather noisy game. But we can see it's fairly simple to get something up and running, and just to show that's not all smoke and mirrors and that we can edit things, if we go to the About screen, it says that it was ported to the iPhone, so let's go and update that. Now, I know that one of the strings in that experimental, what's the word, experimental? If I search and bring it up, okay, we can see it's all Objective-C code here. If I go into the text, I can put a /n and ported to Windows 10 by David Brella. And if we run that again and then load up that About screen, About, we can see it was ported to the iPhone and ported to Windows 10 by David Brella. So hopefully the Canabalt team likes that and they'll port it across to Windows 10. If not, if you have an existing iOS application, it's that easy to just take an existing iOS application, port it across to Windows 10, and then you can go and add the niceties to it, like the splash screen and application icon. So thanks for watching.